This city is one of the most isolated cities on Earth, and it's closer to Indonesia than its capital, Canberra. Despite its isolation, it is one of the fastest-growing cities of Australia. Today, we take a look at the capital and largest city of Western Australia. Welcome to Earth from Space! The metropolitan area of Perth is located in the southwest division of Western Australia, between the Indian Ocean and the low coastal escarpment known as the Darling Range. The metropolitan area stretches around 125 kilometers along the coast, from Two Rocks in the north to Singleton in the south. The central business district and suburbs of Perth, Australia's fourth most populous city, are situated on the banks of the Swan River. Perth's airport is visible just south of the Swan River. Rottnest Island is located 19 kilometers off the coast of Perth. This 19 square kilometer sandy island is known for its population of quokkas, one of the smallest wallaby species in Australia. Several ferries can be seen journeying to and from Rottnest Island and Fremantle Harbour, Western Australia's largest and busiest general cargo port. The most striking feature in this week's image, captured by Copernicus Sentinel-2, is the difference between forested land, visible in dark brown, and agricultural plots and crops, visible in green. Some of the forested land pictured here includes John Forest National Park and the Mundaring, Jarradil, and Yuraling State Forests. The intricate pattern visible in the bottom is the Huntly Bauxite Mine, the world's second largest bauxite mine. Australia is the world's largest producer of bauxite, a raw material used primarily in the production of aluminium. The image also includes the location of ESA's Deep Space Ground Station at New Norcia, about 120 kilometers northeast of Perth. The station supports missions like ExoMars, BepiColombo, and Solar Orbiter, and a new 35-meter diameter dish antenna is planned for the site. The Copernicus Sentinel-2 mission is designed to provide images that can be used to distinguish between different crop types, as well as data on numerous plant indices, all essential to monitor plant growth accurately.
Thank you.